Talk to us, Attorney De Guzman. Why do you think that that a constitutional convention would be a more feasible way to amend the charter?
That's right, because if we compare the constitutional convention mode to the Constituent Assembly and the People's Initiative, there are several obstacles to these two modes, meaning Constituent Assembly. We are having difficulty in arriving at a consensus at the House of Representatives. And for People's Initiative, there are already several questions that crop up in the gathering of signatures and, of course, in obtaining the true and valid consent of the electorate, which are very vital in having a genuine People's Initiative as a way of amending the Constitution.
And where are you so far in the process of filing your petition for changing the or for amending the Constitution for the Philippines to have a federal form of government?
We had already prepared a manifesto stating therein that there is really a need to establish a federal form of government to address the problems of the society. And in order to also have a new perspective and a framework for the Philippine government, kami po ay mayroong manifesto na nagsasaad doon na kailangang magtagumpay ang Marcos Duterte administration, at ang isang paraan po para ito ay mangyari ay kailangang amyendahan ang saligang batas sa pamamagitan ng Constitutional Convention at upang maitatag ang federalismo sa ating bansa.
All right. Attorney De Guzman, what actually keeps you optimistic that your push for a charter change for federalism would actually prosper this time around, considering that when President Rodrigo Duterte was still in power, this did not push through, this did not prosper? What keeps you optimistic this time around?
We are really optimistic that this will happen because we can feel the clamor of people in the countryside that federalism is the key to or the solution to the problems of the country. As we know, our country is composed of several islands, and the better way of giving a governance, or shall we say, effective governance for our people is through the establishment of several states with a federal republic up there, while maintaining the system of parliamentary, presidential, and federal form. Our approach or our proposal is a federal, parliamentary, presidential type of federalism.
And how do you actually convince the public that this push would actually be for the benefit of the Philippines and not just for the benefit of several politicians to stay in power?
Well, we intend to go around the country and explain the advantages of having a federal form of government, and effect also a moral and cultural revolution in the countryside, so that there will be truly a true change in the country. And the people would be able to appreciate the value of having a federal form of government.
Attorney, you mentioned earlier that this push for federalism is to ensure that President Marcos and the Duterte family would actually still stay in power and somehow still govern over the Philippines despite the term limits that are in place under the current constitution. Are you still optimistic that this can happen, considering that there are already frictions between the two camps nowadays?
We are not saying that the purpose of federalism is to allow the incumbent officials of the country to stay in power. We are saying that this is a way of ensuring change in our country, and the best way really is to open the charter to revision, so that the so-called economic provisions, the political changes that we would want to effect would be in place. And we are saying that these are the key provisions to the success of the present administration.
Glad you clarified that, Attorney. Shifting to a slightly different topic, your group describes or identifies itself as a supporter of both the Marcosid of both President Marcos and former President Rodrigo Duterte. Your thoughts that some members of their camps are quite not friendly nowadays?
We are really doing our best in the Partido Federal ng Maharlika to preserve the gains of the Marcos Duterte administration and, of course, for a continuation of the gains that we had under the Duterte administration. We feel that through charter change, using or via constitutional convention, the changes that we would want to effect in our country would come into place.
And do you have a timeline so far with regard to the passage of your manifesto for federalism?
Well, within the next few days or weeks, we are going to come out or to publish the manifesto that the PPM and MRRD and ECC has drafted and has approved, so that initially we will be able to inform the public of the proposals that we have.
And when do you hope to actually convene a constitutional convention if assuming that you would get the proper number of support or adequate support for it?
We propose that Congress calls for a constitutional convention election to coincide with the national and local elections in the 2025 elections.
All right.
By then, once a constitutional convention is formed, that convention will be the one will be tasked with proposing amendments or revisions to the constitution.
How much?
And the same will be submitted to a plebiscite.
All right. Final question, Attorney. How much support do you have so far for a constitutional convention to actually be called in less than a year?
Well, we can feel the pulse of the Filipino people because we have members and officers all over the country. And we have consulted each and every one of them before we came up with this consensus of having charter change via constitutional convention. And we are going to present our arguments or our proposals to the congressmen, and of course to the people for them to act accordingly.
All right. With that, thank you so much, PPM National Secretary General Attorney Orly de Guzman.
Thank you to Ms. Trisha.